Let me first start with some good news. It is not always the case. As you know, last week, the European Commission launched its autumn forecast. And I see all the Baltic states ranking among the best. It is the case with Lithuania, with expected growth around 3.6. It is the case with Latvia, with expected growth more than 4%. It is the case with Estonia, with expected growth around 3%. And in general, after 5 years of extremely difficult financial, economic, and social crisis, Europe again emerges as a growing area. And this is a good news. Because this has to be seen connected with all efforts made in terms of fiscal consolidation, in terms of structural reforms. And now we can also expect positive evolution regarding the level of employment, and this is extremely important. And I said that because, as you know, the general context is extremely important when we are speaking about ecology and job. I mean, ecology, sustainable development, and job economic development. I will essentially develop 2 points. First, higher education, science and research are absolutely key for economic development and sustainability. And second, we should organize the things ensuring better and more connection between professors, universities, higher education on the one hand, and industry, private sector, real worlds on the other hand. First of all, science is key for economic development and sustainability. Certainly, this is crystal clear, there is no possibility to develop anywhere competitive economies without investing more in science, in research and innovation. And let me be clear, there is a clear correlation between the level of high-tech export and the level of competitiveness. There is also a clear correlation between the existence of competitive economies and the commitment, the clear commitment and presence of private sector at the heart of research and innovation investment. In the most competitive economies, because also of a good environment, private sector is representing 70% of the total of investment in research and innovation. Let me say also, Europe is strong regarding basic research, as you know. We have every year, it is the case this year again, many Nobel Prizes. We have excellent universities, one-third of top-class universities. But at the same time, we have some difficulties to shift from basic science to applied science. We have some difficulties to use really the new knowledge and to turn knowledge into new products and new markets. And accordingly, we should correct some things and improve our capacity to be more efficient. And for that, it is important to go in two directions. First of all, clear priorities. The lack of priorities is absolutely terrible, and it is impossible to be efficient with lack of capacity to identify clear priorities, key sector by key sector. And the second point is quality of spending. We will have Horizon 2020, and you said rightly, with 70 billion of euros. But again, it is not only the amount of money available, it's our capacity to use this money properly and adequately, oriented to clear priorities. And in the context of ecology and job, it will be important to have in mind two or three key aspects. First of all, the importance of CATS, the key enabling technologies. I mean nanotechnologies, micro and nano electronics, advanced materials, biotechnology, photonics. All these CATS are crucial regarding the capacity to put in place not only a new knowledge economy, but also to shift into the direction of a low carbon economy. And this is absolutely fundamental. You refer also, Madame, regarding the importance of energy. Let me say, obviously, there is a need to do more regarding energy efficiency. We are progressing regarding renewable energy. We have many efforts to develop in addition regarding energy efficiency. But energy efficiency, having in mind again clear priorities, and I see three priorities for energy efficiency. First, efficient building. We are consuming 40% of energy in our housing sector. And it is not possible to continue to pay only attention to new building. We should pay also more and more attention to the existing park, representing 99% of the park. And 80% of this park has been built at a time we had no code, no norm. And accordingly, we have a lot to do in order to improve insulation of existing buildings in particular and to save really energy. The second priority has to be oriented to clean vehicles in two directions. First of all, electric vehicles for urban area, where we need clean, short-distance cars. And for the rest, we should also improve the functioning of engines, improve quality of materials to build vehicles, and improve quality of fuel, because you know, we have in Europe today 270 million of vehicles. 270 million of vehicles. And we have 270 million of vehicles functioning through combustion engines. Accordingly, we should well use our money available in order to go in these two directions. And the third priority is for clean equipment, electric equipment in particular. Regarding the need to ensure better connection between universities, higher education in general, and industry, we should do more and better. And in particular, explaining the needs of society and industry more and better at an early stage to universities and scientists. And at the same time, scientists have to be probably more open to the needs of society. Because you see, when scientists are in situation to know more regarding evolving capabilities and needs, resources can be allocated effectively and knowledge can be used more efficiently. This is fundamental, and we will take new initiative in order to ensure a better connection between, on the one hand, higher education and universities, on the other hand, policy makers and industry business. Thank you very much for your attention.